Presence of Mr. soon to be Mrs. Coon. And we just got back from the hotel. We're gonna go decorate the hall today. Gotta carry some stuff downstairs.
Shoes!
I don't know where my hat went.
Shoes! Dad?
Shoes!
Where's your mom?
Shoes!
What? Where's mom?
I'm walking around foot.
Oh, yeah. Did you really? These are Shannon's decorations. Jacob's dressed up for the day's activities and made himself some
waffles
with the new waffle iron. This is the reception hall. Isn't it beautiful?
Hi, Mom. Hi,
Dave. I have to show you all these beautiful flowers that Beth has. We're in the midst of an executive decorating committee meeting. You've got some beautiful things here.
Thank you. Oh, you're taking pictures. You're the crack up mother.
These are so pretty.
My question to you is this.
Yes, ma'am.
What is your schedule?
What are these things you're doing, lady?
Programs.
Miss Bride. Does she have a clue what she's doing here, folks? These look beautiful. Very pretty.
Bev, do you just want me to put these in here?
Sing to me, Jake.
Okay, am I taking the town country car? Or
what?
I think I'm taking you guys' car to get those girls.
We got a lot of work to do.
Shannon,
it's 11 o'clock. Okay, that's cool with me.
Anything else you need out of there?
No, I think I got it all.
I need the key.
Could put a basketball hoop in the end of this place. Right, Troy? Could put a basketball hoop in here. He's the kind of legs you need on a day like this, Aunt Bev. Right? Roller skates, roller blades. Here's Mickey with the flowers and the bulbs. He's doing a good job for you, Jake. Reed and Kyra just got here. They're helping us put tablecloths on.
30-40 years ago. But over the years, the fight has taken over.
That
can't hardly catch anything else.
That little pond we had on Schoolcraft, we caught some pretty decent-sized bass. Not monsters, but pretty decent-sized ones. A lot of sunfish and bluegill.
Mitered corner?
I don't know.
No. Did she ever go to nursing school?
No. Did you?
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to give you a T-pin.
This is pretty fabric. Ooh, I like that.
Okay, so it goes on from here. This goes on.
All right, ladies, we're making good progress here. Watch these napkins being folded. Let's see how it's done. Do a napkin folding demo.
Right. There's a lot of technique behind it here.
This is Molly. She's Shannon's friend that just arrived from the airport. And she is going to give a demonstration today on how to fold a napkin.
Right. So you got four layers. You're going to peel them back slowly.
See?
Press them down. That's about all there is to it.
You're going to be on Christopher Lowell's show next week.
Exactly. Next Martha Stewart.
Martha Stewart. Now, Ashley, let's see how yours are looking.
Oh, no. Are you going to compare me to Molly? I'm not doing so well.
This is Ashley. Folded in half.
Yeah, unfortunately, I don't think I have a career as a caterer. Wedding planner, I am not.
She's a talented girl.
Oh, yeah. See, I just did it wrong.
I'm making you nervous, huh?
No, actually, every time I do it wrong, and then I have to fix it. Somehow I'm not learning my lesson.
They're looking good.
I'm impressed.
Ooh.
This is nice.
Isn't that pretty? This whole place is pretty. Hey, Ashley's got it down now. Very good. Very good.
Thank you.
All right. Let's see how Meg's doing. Okay, Meg.
I don't really do videos.
You don't do videos. We'll just do your napkin.
Okay.
All right.
This is my technique here.
She's got it down, too.
Ash, what time did you wake up this morning? 4.
Oh, my word.
Yeah, we went to bed at 12. We got up at 4. And here we are.
Trina.
Chipper.
Chipper and folding napkins for the rest of the afternoon.
She hasn't learned fully, so she's just fanning. So
that's right. She's the fan lady, huh? Shannon has no clue what she's doing over here with the T-pins. Miss T-pin. Those are interesting little pins you got there.
They're not really pins, they're just clips.
It's looking good. We've only been here for 4 hours. We have tied 10 million knots since I arrived. There's hope for this place. It's going to come together, the tuxes. And it is 1:15 in the afternoon.
Hi, Alexis. I want your jacket. I think that's so cute.
Thank you.
I like that.
Wait for the camera. Hi.
She has a one-track mind right now. She has French
fries. Hey, she got a French fry. She's looking good.
She's so hysterical. Doesn't she look like a who?
She's beautiful.
She's a little who baby.
There's Aunt Rachel.
Lexi. Alexis.
She's like, for real, let me eat my fries.
Hi, Stinky.
She's so sweet. This is the banquet table.
Where's your mama?
You got a long way to look up there, Troy.
Thank you.
See it.
I find it funny.
Okay. You gonna have your salad? You gonna eat a salad? You guys are looking good, making good progress. We got 20 minutes, so.
20 minutes, huh?
Plenty of time. You only need one boob today, right, Lindsay? You only got time to feed one boob today, huh?
Mom!
That's all right.
You put my tan last.
Shannon, your hair looks really pretty. This is not the music for the bride.
Are you sure I can't pick her up?
No, she's
no.
Just...
Don't even go near her, the mother says.
It'll tire her out to cry.
The dad's out there.
Mickey?
It'll tire her out.
That baby got 5 hours of sleep last night.
No, you want me to walk her till she falls asleep?
Oh, no.
She won't fall asleep. Oh, I did get deodorant on it.
Can I take her?
Yeah, you can walk her.
You can hear it really loud up in the church, so I think that's why he came down. I think it's the ductwork. Is that okay, Rachel?
I was good. Pat deodorant on.
She has her homing device on. I'm freezing. She has her homing device on.
Do you want your coat?
She's like my mother is now 20 yards away, 30 yards away.
Do you want your coat?
Not yet, because your mom has to do ribbon.
But the coat's taller than that.
I think
that's
what it is. Yeah, I guess so. My diva coat.
Your diva coat?
Now stand nice. Be nice.
Shannon. Thorman's jealous, I know.
I am jealous.
That is so cute.
Shannon, you're standing a little tense.
It's freezing in here. You need to bring a space heater. Mom, I need you to speak with Aunt Marie about telling Bridget when to...
Who is Bridget?
Bridget
is... Daddy!
The book like the caterpillar, and you have a ribbon blanket.
Daddy!
Did you see the baby
close
in that book?
I'm done whenever Shannon...
You're done?
Yep.
Oh, she can't keep her eyes open.
Oh, sleepy. Look at you,
lady. Hi, Case. How'd it go? Were they up there?
Yeah, they're good. Everyone was there but Justice, so I just...
That's fine. I told Justice he'd come later because he's grumpy and...
Mickey? Yeah, it was
perfect. Julie didn't have socks for him, and I said to come after.
They were great.
Okay, awesome. Okay.
It was really painless.
Even if everything went wrong, he'd be like, yeah, I'm great! Do you like my diva coat, Case?
You look like a big hottie.
It's awesome.
It's hot. Awesome. So hit. Oda's gonna have to start mass producing them for all the girls. We picked this out as like, can I have a boa somehow? I really want a boa.
I know. Is this the first time you've ever tried that coat on?
No, I've tried it before.
Okay. Because she just like made it. She was just like, well, I guess this will work.
No,
she
just like made it. I tried it on, it fit, and it was done.
Something like that at the bottom.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Shannon's like, whatever.
Whatever we do is all right.
Who's taking my bag?
Lauren, I don't know where your bag is.
Rachel, can you do my shoes?
Well, that's
it. I'm not supposed to help you with
stuff. Yeah. He calls me at 10 o'clock at night.
My bag needs to, like, be ending up.
Excuse me.
Watch out, Casey. Or, I mean.
Is that this? I expect him to be here.
My bag needs to end up in...
If you put it with my photography stuff, I'll put it in there and take it to the reception.
Don't forget, girls, before we go up, you all have to have your gloves on.
Okay.
We're going to need them today in here.
That's right.
Yeah, seriously.
What hole is it on?
I should make coats for everybody.
Oh, if they're going in?
Did
yeah,
you make
good.
All of the dresses?
Right,
oh, no.
Okay.
No, we couldn't go that far. Could we?
Shannon's on fire.
We need look at all here. It's like
when I videotape it here, all you see is the steam rising. Mother, nothing's torn on your butt.
Back there, over on that
Olivia,
side.
Olivia,
go
come over here. Right here. You want her?
No, that's fine. Okay. That's fine.
I think that's best we're gonna do. Girl.
Do it again. She's gonna take a photo.
Of me steaming you?
Yeah.
It's exciting.
Just so nice. Oh my God.
All right, Shannon.
No, I
will
come.
Let me know,
I'll be like,
hold a high on hand. Like one for a couple.
Okay, Jack, you're doing that model. There you go. A little bit more. There you go. Great. No. Great. Okay, that's the end of the roll. So you can go up to the altar.
It's kind of dark.
Well.
Oh, I know. Because we shut the flash off last night. So we didn't get in trouble.
Okay.
She's gray hair.
Put your chin down a little. There you go. A little further. There you go. No.
It's not very long.
The
so
yeah.
Show.
Except for that one.
Here?
Yeah. Yeah, that looks good. Okay. Okay. So you look over here. Okay.
Should I take my jacket off too for a couple?
We will. Okay. Relax your shoulder down. There you go. Stand up straight, relax. Okay. Drop your chin down and turn your head, looking at my finger. There you go. Down. There you go. Look more over here, chin down. Oh, yeah. Okay. And then there's three more. Four. Okay. Lauren, you're next to Leah. Kelly, you're next to Lindsay.
He's looking good.
Oh, wait, she's even with the guy in Coral. And Rachel is next to Lauren. Yeah. And Olivia, in here, you come with me.
You
okay. You're going to stand next to your hairdresser. You're going to stand next to Kelly. Okay.
Is that she's going to wait?
We'll adjust it in a second. Shannon, you're straight up. You. Okay, can you back up at all?
Me?
Can all of you guys back up at all? No?
Yeah.
Okay, come in a little bit, Kelly. Come in a little bit. Well, we can have the pews in on both sides, kind of frames it. Okay, so Olivia, can you take both your hands and put them on your side. Just relax. Go like this. Ooh. Ooh. Ah. The big smile, like when you take your pictures at school. Or on your birthday, when you have a birthday party, and they're like, smile! No smile. Okay. So, Kelly, can you scoot in just a little bit more?
You'll smile, right, when she says 1, 2, 3?
Yeah. Okay, you guys relax. You look great. Beautiful handmade bouquets and necklaces by the one and only Shannon Murphy, the Murph Dog. Okay, big smiles, Olivia. Hello, big smiles. Looks like you might fall over. You relax? Okay. Yeah, that's good. That's good. Olivia, can you look at me? No. Big smile. 1, 2, 3. Okay.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Nope, you go ahead. Nope.
Can you relax to them?
I see them.
That's a good smile, Olivia.
There you go, kiddo. Okay, ladies.
Everybody at the camera.
No yawning.
It's coming. There.
Big yawn. I didn't see that. Yeah. 1, 2, 3. Olivia, smile! Big smile! Okay. Rachel, can you hold your book bit down just a little bit? There you go. Perfect. Don't want to get in front. You want to hide that beautiful face of yours? Come on. Big smile. Looking at the camera, 1, 2, 3, everyone say, Olivia! Woo! Very nice. Good job. That's a good one. We had kind of a fun one with the boys. That they were holding joy across all of them.
Are you serious?
Yeah. We could do that with Olivia if she would like.
So everyone had a statue pose of mine for themselves.
Sure.
Use your own creative.
Let's pick a
bride.
No.
That's after,
not before.
We haven't had a separate wedding.
Just make sure you guys are all.
Oh, look.
Okay.
Lexus. Look this way. Lexus. Come here.
There you go. Okay, smile. Smile, lady. She's doing good. 1, 2, 3. Yeah.
That's
okay.
Tell her again. She'll come.
Lexus.
Pretty girl.
There you go.
Over here.
Yeah, nice. Look at me. Okay, yeah. Very nice. Very good.
Girl.
She's right. A good kiddo.
Lexus, look this way. Look this way.
Look at me, Rachel.
Good girl. You are sweet.
Rachel, can you scoot in just a little bit more? Yeah, there you go.
Oh, you got a good smile on that one.
There's a lot of people. Sam, look at me. We'll get the baby. Everybody, look at me.
Lexus.
Are you ready?
There we go. Got it. That was a great one.
Okay.
No, I want one.
Alexis! Alexis! Alexis!
Woo! Good.
phase one. Yep. You guys get together, close. Push in, we're gonna just do like a big shot. How about you two on top, come in. Lauren, you're gonna come down. Mom's up, Lauren's down. There you go. Okay.
That's gonna be beautiful.
Yeah. You guys are great. Okay. Big smiles. One, two, three. Okay, let's try another one. Are you guys dying? You're almost there, you're doing good. You're doing good.
Excellent.
Lauren's like, I'm gonna kill you.
Smile.
One, two, three.
Thank you.
Happy have peace with you, as they shall be called the daughters and sons of God. Happy those who are persecuted in the cause of what is right. Theirs is the kingdom of heaven. How happy are you? When they abuse you and persecute you, speak all kinds of calumny against you on account of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. Gospel of the Lord. Thank you. Just as in God is a dynamic process of Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Men and women given to each other to complement one another and to become one. And this happens authentically when it's a covenant of marriage, binding yourself together before the Lord God. The problem is, too many couples see marriage as a contract. You do this and I do that. Quid pro quo. And I personally find this most exemplified by cohabitants. They develop certain arrangements in their living together. Even when they enter into marriage, those same arrangements continue on. They agree on who pays what in the apartment, who does what, and how we take care of things. But the bottom line in that kind of an arrangement is, you do this, I do that. You don't do this, then I don't do that. And it can't last. Couples last. Like contracts. The vows of marriage made authentically are about a covenant relationship. I embrace you for better, for worse, sickness and in health, richer or poorer. No matter what happens, I'm there for you. In a contract relationship or marriage, if you aren't a super salesperson at Cutco, then let's out. If you're the CEO of Vector in a few years, then that's it. If you don't stay as beautiful as you are now, then let's forget. If you don't make the money that I want, I'm going to find someone else. If you don't have the family, if you don't achieve the status in this community, then let's forget. Goodbye. I know. It's a contract. You do and fulfill my expectations, otherwise, forget. In a covenant relationship of marriage, it's far different. The couples are there to help each other, not 50-50, but with my whole self, my whole being. I'll overlook those bad days. We all have them. And we need to let them slide into the past. We need to care for our house and make it a home, a place of love and care. For we know if we do that, the Lord God will bless us and be with us. But it's the most beautiful and magnificent house. Shannon and Jacob, you have fallen in love with each other. This is one of the most wonderful experiences you can possibly have. But the way I see it, too often in our culture, it's superficial. And I'll call it kissy face, patty fingers. In other words, it's only on the surface, nothing more. That's not what John talked about in that second. He said to us, love as God has loved. That's to make a covenant relationship. It means that no matter what happens, I'm there for you just as God is there for us. So much so that he sent his only son to be one with us. We pray for you that you enter into a covenant relationship, not just a contract. Shannon and Jacob, we know that you'll be happy if you do that. If you keep your sense of humor, if you weep tears with each other, holding each other, if you always try to do what's right, if you approach each other always with respect, if you're willing to overlook the oddities of each other, and are willing to forgive, and we pray that your love has only begun, and that you will grow in love for each other with the passing of years and reach old age together. That's our prayer for you, that you enter into this relationship before the Christ abundantly blesses your love. Consecrated you in heaven. Now enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament, so that you may pursue the duties of marriage and mutual capacity. In the presence of this beginning community, I ask you to state your intention. Jacob and Shannon, have you come here freely without reservation to give yourself up each other in marriage? Will you love and honor each other as pleasant as life as the rest of your lives? We accept children lovingly from the Lord God and bring them up in the love of Christ and His church. Since it is your intention, enter into this covenant relationship with marriage. We ask that you to carry your consent before God, this community. You have declared your consent before this church. May the Lord in His goodness strengthen your consent and fill you with His blessings. If God has joined you, go with your body. Lord, bless these rings. Grant that those who wear them always have a deep faith in each other. May they do your will, always live together in peace, goodwill, and love. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Please stand. We have listened to love, God's holy word in the scriptures, seen His presence through the exchange of power. We now present to the Lord our God our petition for the people, all of us.
The response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. For the parents and grandparents of Shannon and Jacob, through whom they have learned many valuable lessons in life and love, may God bless them, granting them outstanding health, happiness, and prosperity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the new marriage of Shannon and Jacob, may it be a blessing to their families, their friends, their neighbors, and their fellow parishioners here at St. Andrew's. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the blessing of children, that God would bless Shannon and Jacob with the gift of children, and that the love in their marriage will enable them to teach lessons of life and love, raising their family in the Christian spirit, as their parents have done for them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God, Father in heaven, your Son taught us to seek to not, we do so with confidence. We look upon our many needs. Consider our trust in faith. Your great love, grant these requests, to make you, through Christ our Lord. My sisters and brothers, let us pray that this offering of bread and wine, together with the good we do, might be acceptable to God and to you, our beloved Father. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, all powerful and ever living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks. You have created us in love to share your own divine life. We see our kind destiny in the love of husband and wife, which bears a imprint of your own divine love. Love is our word. Love is a constant calling. Love is fulfilled with you in heaven. The love of man and woman is made fully in the sacrament of marriage. It becomes a mirror of your own everlasting life. Through Christ, choirs of angels and all the saints praise and worship the glory. May our voices be one with theirs as we say, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. Supper was ended, he took the cup again and gave you thanks and praise, gave the cup of his disciples and said, Take this, all you may drink. This is the cup of did for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of the Lord.
Thank you. Thank you. You've never heard of Fago? Where are you from?
Boston!
Louisiana, New Orleans. She wasn't boring.
Yes. Are we putting it on the body?
Nicely done, nicely done.
Yeah, they did them.
Heart.
Only one blue.
Take it up, take it up.
Uh-oh.
We don't have a
oh my gosh,
we're out.
You know what we should do? We should wrap up. Yeah. We'll get on the other side. Just right. Throw it under and throw it back around.
Yes, you know.
Right.
And then we'll just have to no
children,
no passing.
Yeah, I know.
Table on the next two, don't you, Jake?
Marcy.
Oh, cute. Somebody's too clever.
Thank you. right here and you're going to get a chance to shoot them. I'm going.
Thank you.